Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today is going to be an empties video, and it might be a little long because I tend to talk a lot. So if anything, maybe a drink and a snack wouldn't be a bad idea. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into these products. Now I do have this Ulta bag that has it in here, but it's only half full, but it's a lot of stuff that I have a lot to say about. Okay, the first thing is this Maui Hibiscus Beach Body Wash from Bath & Body Works. This is the old packaging, and I guess that's why when I bought it, it was only $2. This stuff smells amazing, and because it has shea and vitamin E in it, it feels very nice on the skin. My skin doesn't feel stripped or anything like that. I really like it. Probably buy the new one. I thought it smelled a little bit like mango, but maybe that's just me. My husband liked it too, so yeah. The thing in here is the Aussie 3-Minute Miracle, the moist formula, I guess you could say, or moisture, I don't know. Moist is such a weird word. Anyways, I use this more as like a pre-shower treatment or pre-shampoo treatment, especially like from the mid-lengths down. It does help when my ends are looking like complete shit, and it's fairly inexpensive. These go on sale pretty often, especially at CVS, so if you're interested, try looking there. And I think they put a lot of coupons in the Sunday newspaper for it. I'm probably going to continue using this as like a pre-shower hair mask, as opposed to using it in the shower, only because in the shower, to me, it doesn't really feel like it's doing anything. But when I use it beforehand, it makes my hair a lot more manageable. Maybe it's just me. Next thing in here is also from Bath & Body Works. It is the Springtime and Clementines little hand wash. It's a nice refreshing scent. It smells like oranges and I guess, or clementines, however you want to put it. My sister hates the word clementines. We grew up knowing them as mikans because that's what they're called in Japan. So clementines just sounds like an ugly word to me. Or for us in general, but yeah, anyways, it smells really good, it cleans very well. This is one of the soaps that I use before I wash my face and everything. I will wash my hands with this first because I feel like it gets all the nastiness off my hands, and then I'll go in with my facial cleanser and all that good stuff. So I liked it, pretty refreshing scent. Maybe I'll buy another one in the future, who knows. I got like 10 other ones to go through right now, so yeah, there's that. Okay, next thing that's in here is the Mario Badescu Acne Facial Cleanser. This is the trial, travel size, however you want to put it. I mentioned this in my favorites. I feel like it's a really good cleanser. It was never irritating on my skin or anything. It calmed down my acne a lot. But I love this cleanser. It's more effective than Cetaphil, but it's still very gentle. It smells pretty good, I guess. I don't know. It doesn't really have a scent to it. It has just that slight tinge of aloe in it. I'd repurchase it again. It all just depends on how my skincare regimen is going to work for me and all that. So yeah. Next thing in here is also from Mario Badescu, and this is the facial spray with aloe, herbs, and rosewater. As you can tell, this is the smaller size of it. I got it just to try it out, see how it would work for my skin, because I wanted to try like a skin prepping spray type of thing. This broke me out, that's why there's so much still in here. I did for a while use this to spray in my hair, like on second or third day hair and everything like that. So this way it wouldn't smell so like nasty scalp-like, it would just smell like roses, hopefully. But I gave up on doing that. I feel like this was a waste of money for me, but I mean, I guess if people don't have a sensitivity to rose water, I guess this would work great for you. It really sucked on my skin. I think this is the last thing from Mario Badescu that I have in this bag, and it is the whitening mask. This is one of the smaller sizes that comes in the brightening kit, which I loved. This mask works really, really well when you use it with the vitamin C serum that also comes in the kit. The only thing is, a full size of this is $24 and a full size of the vitamin C serum is $45, so it's pretty pricey. I remember really liking this, and the smell of this one, it has like a slight tinge of licorice root, I guess, is what's in it, but it has like that licorice smell, but it also smells really fruity. And I noticed when I was using this, it worked really well on my scarring that I had over here beforehand, before this came along. But yeah, I really liked this one. And the kit in general is a pretty good kit. Just the glycolic foaming cleanser that comes in it is very harsh. It dried out my skin really, really badly, so I had to drop down to using it as a chemical exfoliant like once a week when I was using it. But this mask is like really, really good, or at least I think it was, but I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna get fucking trash talk in the in the comments later for saying that, but you know. Another empty I have is the Neutrogena makeup remover wipes. I got like a big pack of these. I just don't know what happened to like all of them, and this is the only one that I have left, or the only package that I have left. But I've been through like 3 packs of these, and I don't really like them. I just have them, so I decided to use them. They don't really work well on my mascaras, and I don't even use waterproof mascara. It does okay, I guess, when I'm really drunk or if I come home really drunk and I don't feel like doing my whole cleansing routine. I'll use one of these all over my face and it does the job to some extent. I don't feel like my skin is broken out really, really bad in the morning and everything, but it's not the greatest makeup removing wipe. I'll tell you this now. I don't know why people rave about this. It feels like a wet wipe and maybe there's a little bit of oil in it. I don't know. But it's not all that great. That's just my opinion. I actually do have one more thing from Mario Badescu, and this is the Hydromoisture with vitamin C. As you can tell, it is a very small size, and this came in the combination dry kit. I was trying a lot of Mario Badescu skincare kits, and the one thing I don't like about this is that it felt like I needed a lot to moisturize my face. That's what really sucks about this moisturizer. I would have to use at least a quarter size to do my whole face and maybe feel moisturized afterward. But other than that, I mean, it did what it was supposed to, just in hefty amounts. But I don't think I would repurchase like a full size of this. It wasn't all that great to me. So yeah, sorry Mario Badescu, but this was a crappy moisturizer for my skin. So this is the Gotabe, because it has the double dots. I don't know. I'm just gonna say it's Gotabe. Smooth Operator with Cashmere Leave-In Conditioner Luster Lotion. That's a mouthful, I know, but all you gotta do is look for the orange and pink packaging. This stuff is amazing. It's holy grail to me. I especially love it when I know I'm gonna straighten my hair the next day. This is the leave-in conditioner that I will use. My hair comes out silky smooth and basically like stick straight. And having all of this and being able to go from this to like stick straight is amazing to me sometimes. It does leave my hair super soft, super shiny. I love it. Even when I have when I wear my hair natural and curly, this helps keep the frizz down and everything, especially like if at the top of my head it's super frizzy. I'll take a couple pumps of this, run it through the top, not on my roots, but just like the top of my hair and everything to help smooth it out. And it smells really, really good. Like it smells quite luxurious to me. Maybe it's just me, I don't know. But I love this stuff. I've been using it for many, many years. And if you haven't tried it, I would suggest trying it out and everything. With this one too, it always goes on sale at CVS. I know that for a fact from working there. So yeah, you can get this for like $5, and then they always put coupons in the newspaper for it too. So yeah, definitely give this guy a shot if you're looking for a leave-in conditioner. It actually smells pretty decent. And then on top of that, when you flat iron your hair or you straighten your hair or whatever, this doesn't leave like a weird burnt smell in your hair. So that was one thing that I really did like about this too. Another thing that is completely holy grail to me is this mousse here, or these bottles of mousse, I guess you could say. This is the Sauve Professionals Flexible Control Curl Mousse with a level 3 hold. And it's what I have in my hair right now. It doesn't leave your hair crunchy, or at least for me it doesn't leave it crunchy. The only time it does is if I do it on dry hair and I use too much, then it'll get crunchy. But on damp hair, there's no way in hell this will ever get crunchy in your hair. It leaves it really soft and touchable and smooth. It calms my frizz a lot, and I have been using this for God knows how long. I want to say at least 5 or 6 years as well. And I just, I can't get enough of it. And on top of that, this is no more than $3 a bottle. So it's fairly inexpensive, it works really well, and it says that it's compared to the Sebastian mousse, I guess. I don't know, I've never tried it. I go through these almost like water. I put this in my hair like almost every day. So if you're looking for a mousse, or if you're scared of mousse, give this a shot. I only use like 2 golf ball sizes, maybe 3 if I feel like I might need a little bit more. But yeah, it doesn't take a lot for this to work through your hair and make it fabulous. So, yeah, I love this stuff, and I will continue to use it forever and ever, unless they discontinue it, and then I'll cry and be really sad about it. But this is really, really, really good mousse. Next thing that's in here is this Carol's Daughter Sacred Tiare Anti-Breakage and Anti-Frizz Leave-In Conditioner. This was a little sample one, I guess you could say, that came with the shampoo and conditioner in my last favorites. I don't remember feeling wowed by this or anything like that. It just made my hair smell like fresh flowers, which was kind of nice and everything. But it didn't last me long. As you can tell, there's just a tad bit of product in there, but I don't even think the pump can get that. And I don't feel like pouring it into my hands. I guess it was an okay leave-in conditioner. I don't really care much for spray leave-in conditioners. They don't really work for my hair. So, or at least this one didn't work really well for my hair. So I don't plan on buying a full size of this in the future. I used it because it was there. Alright, so this one's not empty, but I am tossing it because I think I've had it for like ever. I want to say like 2 years. And I'm not trying to use two-year-old moisturizer on my face. This is the Simple Hydrating Light Moisturizer. This is what the bottle looks like, and this stuff was okay, I guess. I haven't used this in a really long time, so I don't remember how I felt about it. There's still like a third of the bottle left, I think, and I mean, if I feel like retrying it in the future, I might. I just remember it not being like, wow, I need to use this all the time. It is a very light moisturizer. I remember using it in the winter time, and light moisturizers in the winter are not a good idea. But I guess, yeah, if I feel ambitious and trying it again, maybe I'll do it. But until then, this is going in the trash. Next thing I have is a little sample size from Fresh. It is the Seaberry Moisturizing Face Oil with Omega 3, 6, 7, and 9. This is what the bottle looks like. It's adorable. The only reason why I'm tossing this is because the dropper can't get the last little bit that's there at the bottom. I remember this being a pretty decent oil for my skin, as like as a night moisturizer and everything like that. But I spilled half the bottle on my desk and it made me really angry. And I don't enjoy the smell of this particularly. It does smell like, I want to say kitchen spices or like Italian spices, however you want to put it. And, yeah, it smells like spices that you would have in your kitchen. It doesn't smell like something you should be putting on your face. So I don't think I would ever invest in a full-size bottle, but it did work pretty well when I was using it. I just didn't like the smell very much. Okay, the next three things I have are eyeliners, and they're all minis that I got from the Sephora, like, draw the line kit that they had over the holidays. First one is the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. You guys know that I love and, like, will never give this up. And I think there's a little left in here, but because this one says not to use for longer than 6 months, I am not going to try and put this on my eyes and give myself pink eye or a sty or any kind of eye disease that is unnecessary. But I do really love this liner. Of course, I have the full size, and I will be continuing to repurchase the full size because this is so great. Also, I have a NARS eyeliner. I don't know the full name of this. I think it's like Larger or Longer Than Life. I can't remember. But I remember loving this pencil. The only reason why I'm getting rid of it is because the pencil's not there. I didn't even use all of it. It fell out one day and it made me really upset because this pencil is so good. It's great for the waterline. It's great for tight lining. Doesn't transfer anything. Like once it sets, it's not gonna move. And I would invest in the full size, but the full size price kind of scares me. So until I find that I can't find anything else to work really well for me, I will continue to try new pencil liners. But this one is great. The last liner that I have is this Marc Jacobs Highliner Gel Crayon Eyeliner. The same thing happened with this one where the pencil fell out and everything, and it was very upsetting and all of that good stuff because Marc Jacobs is really expensive. I remember with this one, I liked it because it was a gel consistency. And once it's set, it was like, it was not moving. The downside is that sometimes it takes a little longer to set than others, I guess. I don't know how to put it. But I remember enjoying it. Other than that, it was great. It's cute packaging and everything. And if the full size wasn't so expensive, I might actually invest in it. Last thing in this bag, thank goodness, because this video is probably going to be long, like long as hell, is a sample size of the Bare Minerals Bare Skin Foundation. I got this from Ulta back when I was trying out Bare Minerals a while back, and this is in the shade Bare Natural. I remember when I got this and everything, I loved it, and that's why I wanted the full size one. And then after I got the full size one, like, I hated it, and then I liked it, and now I'm like, I don't really like it, but I guess I'll use it. Like, it just gives me mixed feelings. I've been using it for, like, the last year or so, and it's just, I've never had such a big love-hate relationship with a foundation in my life. So, I mean, it's a good foundation. If you're oily, some people don't like the fact that it's pretty dewy and everything, but on dry skin, it does nothing but accentuate your dry areas of your face and everything. I don't know. The only thing I don't like about Bare Minerals in general is that their shading is weird. Like, the warm tones are too yellow on me, and I'm really yellow. And their neutral shades are too pink on me, and I don't understand, like, why I would have to buy two different colors to mix them and everything just so I could get my perfect shade for them. I just don't love it. So that's all my empties, guys. I'm sorry if this video was really long. It's just that there was a lot of stuff to go through and all that good stuff, so that's why I warned you to get a drink and a snack. I hope that this was, like, actually somewhat not too bad to watch. I know that my videos lately have been, like, super duper long. It's just that there's a lot of information to cram into one video. It's really hard to try and split a video or cut out so much content when it seems relevant. At least to me, it seems relevant to the video, so that's why the best friend tag was so long. And honestly, I put that up so this way Victoria and I have something to look back on and laugh at each other about and all that good stuff. But I'm trying to get my videos to be under 10 minutes and everything like that, so yeah, I'm really sorry that this was really long. I'm thinking maybe every month and a half or 2 months I will do these, so this way it's not so long instead of saving up for like 3 or 4 months, because this was actually pretty ridiculous. Anyways, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, suggestions, anything like that, please leave them in the comments for me, or you can direct message me on here. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. As always, you can follow me on Snapchat or Instagram, more so on Snapchat. So that's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!